Now, students, I hope you understood about what kind of system was there in South Africa, and I hope that you understood what is the apartheid system and how Nelson Mandela fought against it. Now, by this discrimination, by this situation, you can easily be understand that how black people, they were segregated or separated from white people. Just now you came to know that in South Africa, three categories people were living there. First of all, white, they were the ruler, they are the main dominant class. And next one, those are the black, mainly they are the native people of that place. And next one, few Indians, they migrated from our country. They are known as the colored people. So these three kinds of people were living that place, and black were segregated. If you see this condition, situations there, easily you can be understand how that black people, they were separated from the whites. Not only black, migrated Indians also be separated from blacks, from whites, forbidden from living in white areas. Means that area mainly be residential area for the white people. Their black people, they could not live in that place. They lived in totally be in a separate place. And their working condition, their working place also be separate from each other. If any white category people, they gave permission, means if the black people, they got permission from the white people, that time only they can able to enter in their working place. Next one, discriminated while using public properties. All of you know very well what is the meaning of public properties, like public park, hospitals, schools, they are known as the public properties. There also we, you can see lot of discrimination was there. Means there people, they cannot, means black people, they cannot enter, they could not enter, or they can could not use that place where mainly be occupied by the white personals there. Next one, black could not visit churches where white worship from. They cannot form any kind of association there, and also they cannot protest against this kind of situation. Means by this system, this is known as the apartheid system, by which officially black people, they were discriminated from the white complexion people. Fine. Next one, we are going to start. Now we are going to discuss about next topic, how African National Congress, the leaders of African National Congress, they fought against this apartheid system or this kind of discriminated mainly done by the white category. You know very well, in India also, Indian people, they fought under the leadership of Indian National Congress. Same kind of condition was there. That time, African people, they did struggle under leadership of African National Congress, and Nelson Mandela was the leader of African National Congress. Though, in South African people, they started their struggle from 1950, but before that, Mahatma Gandhi also did struggle there. He also favored South African people when he went South Africa for study. In 1915, he did Satyagraha movement in favor of African people. But afterwards, since 1950, blacks, colored and Indians fought against this system, means black colored complexion people, and also be Indians, means migrated Indian, they also be fought against this apartheid system, including workers union, communist and sensitive whites joined them. Means there also be workers union, means trade union, communist political party and sensitive whites, they also be fought against it. In 1964, Nelson Mandela and seven other leaders were sentenced to life imprisonment. Though they started struggle against white complexion people, against the Britishers, that's why Britishers, they sent this Nelson Mandela and another seven leaders, prominent leaders were there in life imprisonment. But the white racist government continued to rule by torturing and killing thousands of black and colored. You know, in India also, so many Indians, they were killed by, tortured by Britishers. Same kind of situation also was there. There also be white racist community. They tortured and killed thousands of black and native and migrated Indians. Then protest increased and the racist government realized that they could no longer keep the black under repression. Means they are cannot suppress people for a long period of time. Racist government now changed their policies. Afterwards, when they estimated, they now unable to control, did same kind of things on black people that time, they changed their strategies, they changed their policies. Discriminatory laws were repealed, but ban on political parties and restriction on the media were lifted. Nelson Mandela was released from jail after 28 years of imprisonment. So that afterwards, that apartheid system totally be abolished from South Africa, and political parties also be banned, and restriction on media were lifted. Before that, lot of restrictions were imposed on media. Now they just lifted that, and Nelson Mandela was released from jail after 28 years of his imprisonment, and he became the first black president, not only for South Africa, for all over the world. He was the first black president. Next, we are going to start towards a new constitution. Means when the South African people, they got independence, they got free, they became free from white people. How they made their constitution, what were the ideals mainly they adopted, fine.